gotta drink a lot of Dr. Pepper every year. Das Fartes is coming to town. He's making a ship, he's checking it twice. Gonna find out if it'll fly real nice. Das Fartes is coming to town. He sees you when you're streaming. He knows if you make mistakes. He knows if your language is bad.
That's hilarious.
So for the community's sake.
That is so, hilarious.
Better install Google Engineer. Better drink a lot of Dr. Pepper every year.
I'm just playing the whole song. Is what I'm doing.
He
gosh.
If you use MacJab, he knows if you have Vims. He spends 4 hours on fashion lights just to crash it in the end. So, you better
Nubius, you're awesome. Google Engineer. You better drink you're absolutely
a lot of
awesome.
Dr. Pepper every year. Das Fartes is coming. Das Fartes is coming. Das Fartes is coming to town.
Pizza is a go is what it is. The pizza is a go, dude. Nubius. That song is hilarious. No, stop there. Okay, that song is hilarious, Nubius. I am doing good. Where's the other stuff? I need to come over here. I need to do this. I need to go over here. I still need to make this the thing at the end that just has it sit. I didn't do that. I slept a lot because I was very, very, very kind of rusty after the stream last night. But that's okay because I'm back in action. Oh, brother. That's how this party's going to go tonight. That is what's going to happen. So there's chiptunes. The volume's okay, yes. Mods. I think Nightbot is dead right now. I think Nightbot is dead. What visual mod do I use? LarryJ87. What visual mod do I use? Right now, I've only got a texture replacer, which does my skybox in my .90 career save. But I'm waiting for some of the other big things to get officially updated, and then I'm going to put in the pretty mods. That is what I'm going to do. Let's see here. I've got this. I've got that. I'm all set up. Oh, I can't stand up enough. Cable. All right, wait. Ah! My Dr. Pepper shirt on. Heck yeah. Got the Dr. Pepper shirt on. I'm here for your blood. I don't even understand what that means, sleepy hipster space travel, but welcome back. Your family should be off work by the last 45 minutes because you said 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, and it's now, or you said 6 p.m. Mountain Time. And it's now 8:45 my time, so 6:45 your time. We've got this, we've got that. You know what would be good? Should I just stream Clicker Heroes? I could just stream Clicker Heroes for an hour. Do you want me to stream Clicker Heroes? Look, this is just going to make the back thingy go. Here, we'll just stream some Clicker Heroes right quick. Chill out. I need to do the Dark Ritual right quick. Hang on. And Dark Ritual, then we'll reload it. I don't know why I bother to reload it. Yeah, the entire computer lags when I do this. Yep. Yep. Now I look like I'm in a bad Japanese movie. Oh no, Gorilla! It's just that monitor capture. I think I've narrowed it down. See, now I'm good. I've narrowed it down to the monitor capture and the fact that a Windows arrow is on. I was looking at that a little bit earlier. But, it's almost time to be in space. Come on, Clicker Heroes. You need to just stop this. Level up this Dreadnought guy a little bit. Alright, good deal. Then we can close the entire shenanigan. Clicker Heroes, any Clicker Heroes in the house? The computer can't handle Clicker Heroes, yeah. Don't search for it if you just don't do it. You're so pumped, dude. Boborigami 12. Welcome. I believe, did we get the channel heroes started? I know, right? Clicker Heroes is like, I do it like 2 or 3 times a day. I can quit anytime I want. But I do it 2 or 3 times a day. Yes. There we go. I'm going to close down these things. I'm going to close down all these windows, so I'm not going to be answering messages or anything like that. No, Clicker Heroes link. No, Saiyan. Saiyan, dude. Wait, where's the picture of Saiyan's moon landing? I got it on Twitter. Wait, I got it. Where does it go? Das Valdez. Twitter. Ah, I got it. Okay, there we go. Stuck the landing. Nope. No, you didn't stick the landing. You stuck Jeb there. That's different. Let me get this. Can I get a link to the copy image URL? Heck yeah. Oh, wait. Well, I got to get into the game. So let's do that. Let's do that. Oh, man. I was going to bring it up on the stream. I'm not even in the game yet. Ah! Eek! This is the time when I'm supposed to have the game open right here. Oh, no. We still have a song. Win beta 090. Come on. Open up for me, girlie. Whoa. Keep it classy. There we go. This is the next song. I've got pizza. I've got Kerbal Space Program. I've apparently got a Red Bull. Usually don't do that, but... Ay-yi-yi-yi-yi. What did I miss? Dirt Diver. Oh, yeah. It usually takes about a week. I usually do that on Sunday. All bad. I change these batteries so often that I leave the cover off. Here's this coming up. Nobody wants to look at me. Y'all probably want to look at this. Wait, that's not it. That's not what you want to see. That's not it at all. That's what we want to see right there. All right. I'm looking quite dapper is probably not the right word. It's the Dr. Pepper shirt. I think the Dr. Pepper shirt. Oh, Casper. Check that out. Check that out. Saiyan, dude, congratulations on your moon landing. I'm going to bring it up right quick here. Boy in blue, you're bermed permanently. If I don't like what I see, you're going to be how I made my UFO. Oh, okay. You're not bermed permanently. Bright and fair, Hall. You're not bermed permanently. I will totally load this up, and I will bring it up later. I love the screen cap software / video camera you used. But dude, thank you for posting that up. That one's cool with me. Feeling Depper. Yes, I'm feeling Dr. Depper. I'm feeling Dr. Depper. Oh, there's Nubius Maximus. Oh, there's Saiyan. Oh, here's a game. You know what we don't even have? We don't even have a sandbox. Oh, man. We don't even have a sandbox save. I didn't even put my flag in here yet. Ay-yi-yi-yi-yi. We need a sandbox save. We're going to do KSA Help Desk here. And so if you're new to my streams, you know that when I put the help desk in the title, that means you can ask me questions, and I will answer them for you. That is what I do at my help desk streams. So if you've got any sorts of questions, I'll be doing some little missions and stuff like that. Usually what I try to do is take a bunch of questions and make them into a bit of a mini mission, and then answer the questions as I do the mission. So it may be like, oh, can you launch a space station into space? And can you put a space station around Duna? And how do you do interplanetary transfers? And I'll roll all three of those things up into one mission, and I'll do a mission, and I'll answer the things as we go. T-Game lurking in the shadows. I see you, T-Game. You literally bought Dr. Pepper to drink at work today. I swear I should get paid by those people. I should probably get paid. Is the sound okay? I feel like the sound's not quite okay. I feel like my voice is a little rusty, but what else is new? I've got this. Ah, my flag. Let me take care of that right quick. And I am going to be answering questions. I am going to be flying rockets. I'm going to be crashing things. I'm going to be eating pizza. It's going to be a good time. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe it's going to be a terrible time. Maybe you're going to hate it. Who knows? Oh, I really need to get the Dr. Pepper fuel tank as well. I think that one's 0.90 compatible. I don't know. But I have a very good feeling that it should be compatible with 0.90. What do we call it, by the way? Is it 0.90? Is it .90? How have we been saying that out loud? Because I don't even remember. KSA. There's KSA. And then I can copy that one over. Excellent. And then I can go get my flag. My flag, where's it at? My flag's in Game Beta Squad, isn't it? I believe so. Squad. Flags. Yes. All right. Squad. Come on, squad. Squad. Okay, it's coming up. Good deal. It's beta than ever. Beta than ever. Version 0.9. Question, what's the most favorite thing of the donations so far? Noob K, kicking off the stream with a $5 donation, man. Thank you for that. I appreciate you, Noob K. Are you vintage? I just saw you part. I saw you come in, then part, then I saw you come back out again. I watch these things. Dude, Noob K, thank you for letting me do this for a living. It's people like you that make it so that I can get on stream and eat pizza and answer questions about an awesome video game. 0.9, ew, I guess. Again, Noob K, I appreciate you. Just say beta than ever. I'm with Gav. Gav said what? Actually, where's the... Well, Gav is like up at the top of the screen. Gav just stuck his tongue out. Wait, no, that's Gav. Hang on. Let's see, what did Gav say? Oh, right there. 0.90. Okay, 0.90. 0.90, I'll try to say that. Nightbot's dead, apparently, so the banhammer's gonna be swinging like crazy. Who knows? It should automatically redrone. Listen to this! That's the sound of me being late. Heartland Media! Thank you for the host. Appreciate you. Let me get this done. Come on. I'm late. We need to... Hey, look, ESA flags. That's cool. Huh. Where did those come from? Anyways. That's Win Beta. That's... Oh, my flags aren't in here. Oh, that's the modded save that doesn't have my flag in it. Ay-yi-yi-yi-yi. Mm-hmm. What's the best order to upgrade the KSC buildings? Polomius MB, that's a great question. I would usually probably start with the launch pad because that 18-ton limit is a killer. I have not yet landed on the moon with point or with 18 tons. I believe maybe you could land on the moon. I don't know if you could get back from the moon on 18 tons. So it would be a Gilligan's Island sort of trip if you wanted to go out there and complete the moon mission early on until you upgrade the launch pad. Then I would probably go for the mission control because mission control gives you more contracts. More contracts gives you more money and science. That's probably the order I would do that. Dude, that's a great question. Abstract Backpack, what's going up? I've got this right. Yeah. KSP Kamuchi with 5 viewers. You been cheating on me, Kamuchi? What's going on here? 5 viewers on your channel? Thanks for the host. Oh my goodness, let me do this. I'm in game storage. There's my old Win25 one. There's game data. There's squad. I'm so late. I have no clue what I'm doing. Squad, flags. Ah, found it. I've got you. And that's, yeah, okay, there we go. I've got it. Okay. Oh, don't I have to like refresh something to get this to come up? Probably. The stream is spooling up. The song is winding down, though. This makes me sad. There we go. Start a new one. Talk to me about my flag being in here. Oh, man. I'll just change it on the flagpole. There we go. That one's sufficiently ugly. Actually, I love this retro Jeb Junkyard one. Don't ask. Question, how do you use the suicide burn calculator? I will teach you in this stream. Let's do a suicide burn. That sounds like a great question to me. KSA help desk. Helping desks since 2014. Sandbox, Jeb's Junkyard. That's probably where most of this stuff is going to end up. Kamuchi has good music too. You got to restart the game. Can't you just come over here and click on the flag? Nope. There was a thing you could do. Thanks, Gene Kerman. By the way, squad, anyone from squad who's listening, we need more stuff like this. We need more stuff that pops up once for new players. We need it for experience. We need it for science. We need more stuff like this in the game that gets the new players kind of kickstarted. This guy up here, Gene Kerman, with his information, where's my finger? There we go. Gene Kerman up there, he is very important. We need more stuff like that in the game. Are there any new parts? Jax Hammer, there are so many new parts. There are so many new parts. Fix your laptop and headset. Good job, Mysterious Maze. T-Game will do the suicide burn. Let me open up the official help desk log here. Roop. The official help desk log, and I'm going to officially log your question, and we will show you how to use that suicide burn calculator. It does work. You just got to understand how it works. No horizontal velocity is your first rule there. No horizontal velocity is your first rule. I'm going to scroll through chat. That adds more tip windows. We don't need a mod, Sarian. We don't need a mod. We need that in the stock game. We do not need players to need to install a mod to learn how the game mechanics work. It needs to be right there in the game. But I believe you've been doing some cool stuff with that, right? Uh-huh. Caught another stream. Yeti question with planes and KSP. What am I missing? Incredibly bad atmospheric flight. Ah, yes. I will answer that one for you, too. Guys, we're doing the help desk right now. If you've got questions on Kerbal Space Program 0.90, anything you don't know, like how do you get EXP and how do you do this and how do you do that, ask them now because I'm going to be answering some questions here. That's what we do at the help desk. Also, same deal as last night. If we get over 500 concurrent viewers, I'll do a giveaway of the game. question, what program do I use? Netapier, I can handle that one right now. That is Better Twitch TV chat popped into a new window set to chroma key setting. Better Twitch TV set popped into a new window that I sized to a specific size with the black chat chroma key setting. That's what I do with that. Send me a message and I can send you more information on that. Polomius MB, I've answered your question. What order do we upgrade the VAB buildings? That is absolutely a great question. That is a really great question. And I'd say upgrade that pad first and go for mission control. Breno Russa, thanks for the follow, Breno. Appreciate you. Better than ever. Question, what's the most favorite thing? Only name that worked. I like the new contracts. what else do I like? I like the fact that I was forced to go out and do a moon landing without nodes and that sort of stuff. All that sort of stuff. I like those things. I haven't got to the new space plane parts yet. We're going to be working on those next week is when I'm going to do the new space plane parts. But I'm really loving... Oh my gosh, the editor is... I think just far and above the editor is my favorite part. The new VAB editor is freaking light years ahead of what we had before. I love it. How to make good planes. We got that one. Magnets, how do they work? Magic. How do you get your first interplanetary transfer? How would you do your first interplanetary transfer? Ride car, I'd go to Duna. I did that one last night. How would you do your first interplanetary transfer? I did that one last night. And I will be doing that again. Maybe I can get one in here. We'll see if we can get one. You bought Dr. Pepper. There we go. All right, we're all good. What's a good mission after landing on the moon? Mex, did you do Minmus? You need to go to Minmus. Question, do the game physics allow to build a boat? Absolutely. Of course you can, Saiyan, dude. Of course you can. Of course you can. And Gav has... Saiyan's polite. And Gav uses his politeness to backstab him. I heard you do that in your own channel, Saiyan. I was paying attention when you said that. So you were being all polite and honorable, and Gav just comes in with a flying backstab and just nails you. Nice. let me see. I'm going to close this. Can you go over Kerbal Alarm Clock? I gotcha. I can definitely do that for you. Larry J. Let me see what else I have. Das, having 5.1 million entries in my output list. That's probably not good, KSP Kamuchi. Why do some people, Commando Solo, why do some people donate to me? Apparently it's because bought the game today because of you. Commando Solo, man. I appreciate the donation. I also appreciate your support and squad and buying the game. I hope you have many, many, many fun hours of crashing rockets. I hope it doesn't destroy any personal relationships you may have. But I really do appreciate the support, Commando Solo. Thank you so much for the donation. I do appreciate it. Oh my gosh. Mugger! Saw you in Monev's channel. What's going on, Mugger? Welcome to Kerbal Space Academy. We're doing the help desk. Why do some people have red boxes around them? That's because they said DOS or question. You'll see that when you said that, your question was actually highlighted. Ride car, I did scroll up and get all the questions. With EXP, can you plant flag first in orbit in another mission? Do you get EXP for the orbit? Red Tango, that's a great question, actually. I don't think so. I think it's just the highest thing you've done on each body. Make a basic ship. Albad, you need to come to boot camp tomorrow. Explain Delta V. Delta V. Smooth, I'm going into... excuse me. I'm going into that in great detail tomorrow. I will do a Delta V explanation, kind of a shorter explanation for you. I will absolutely do that. If you're new to my channel, I'm going through, I'm reading questions right now. I'm going to answer these questions during my help desk. Ready to learn about this game, dude, Quaker dude. How did the demo go? Last night you downloaded the demo. You were telling me you were going to download it and give it a look. I'm talking far too slow. Let's bring this up. You now understems. You also, you now understems. What are you, Roots? Can you show the new multi-fueling tanks off one? Oh, Theater, that's actually a great plan. Let me put that down. Let me put that down. Bring! And anything else? I'm seeing if I missed any questions. There's the mod adding more tips. Excellent. Don't look. This is Dr. Pepper. It's like Dr. Pepper Plus. Scary fast. Scary fast with the donation and the stuffed cat. Is that the cat from Sabrina the Teenage Witch? I think it is. You've taught me a bunch, but I'm still terra bad. That's okay. It's just practice. I hope to catch the boot camp tomorrow if it's in the evening. It's going to be 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time until 8 or 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. 2 p.m. to 10 p.m. So if you're Eastern Standard Time, you'll catch part of it for sure. But scary fast, man. Thank you for the donation. 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time to 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Around there tomorrow. around there tomorrow. Thank you again for the support. You guys are so awesome for letting me do this for a living. I'm just talking right now. I haven't even crashed a rocket. I think I've caught everything. Mix, I answered that one. Do the game physics allow for a boat? I got that one. I'm scrolled way up right now. Boot camp is tomorrow. You know that. Bean, you got to get closer, Bean. You got to get closer before you can set that Kerbal as your target. You can't do it from a long ways away. You cannot do it from a long ways away. What's up, Doss? Can't wait for boot camp tomorrow. Okay, got that one. Asymmetric lift systems. Oh, wow. Asymmetric lift systems. I'm going to copy that one down, but that's a full stream. That's not really a help desk question, but that's a full stream. Guys, these are great questions. These are like the greatest questions I've ever got during a help desk. Rescue Jeff from Strays to Brostash. Good job, cadet. Thanks, Doss. You understand. Okay, question. How do you apply the giveaway? You're never here during one. Nimman, you got to hang out till I do one. Quack, wait. Murr, we got a cow in here. I thought I smelled something methane-y. Quetzy, what's up? What is up, Quetzy? Dude, folks, I hope we got a link for Quetzy in there. Brain Fried, of course you can upgrade a Kerbal X. Of course you can, you little trolly McHelperson. You're like a troll helper. Can you debug my crafting help desk if I upload it? Yes, everybody knows that, and you know that too, dude, but I appreciate you asking the question. If you didn't know, if you upload a craft to Kerbal X and it's stock, that's a requirement. I'll actually bring it up on the game here, and I'll help you debug it if you're having problems. You can do that. Give Kerbal X some love. Sir's first admin project on hard mode to get the most benefit. Money. Aisher, money. Always get money first. Get money and then put some money aside and don't spend it in case it hits the fan. You give up? What's up, Outpost Tarantara? Is it safe to drink that or will he explode? I don't know. Find out later on KS Heavy Help Desk. I love it. I was too tired to really focus, but I played a lot today and I'm going to enjoy watching the next days. Das, heck yeah, Quaker dude. Good to hear. I'll be there. Type your name. Okay, what is the airspeed velocity to unplay and swallow? Is it African or European? Das, won't miss the first couple hours, but I'll be here for the rest. Thanks. No problem, Scary Fast Man. Thanks for coming by. Das, question. Basic plane building. Yes, we will do that. Now let's build. Boy in blue, we're getting there. I'm getting. You guys are trying to out chat me, aren't you? I played some VAB upgrade at 210k. You just Labyrinth Star. Labyrinth Star. You can get 210k pretty easily. You can get 210k pretty easily. Put that satellite up that can transmit science data and farm those contracts like crazy. Ah, Peter Dinklage short. I will totally put this in here. You're getting krakenized. I'm doing good, Convio. I'm doing good. What's a good thrust weight on lift height? Nate H. 121, 1.17 on the pad if you're in stock aerodynamics. 1.17 on the pad. I copied you down. Cyrak. Ah. No. No. The Cyrok. The Cyrok incident. He sent me a message. He sent me a message. We gave him 10 minutes to claim his prize. And like 2 or 3 hours later, he sent me a message. He's like, I had to step away. Did I win? He's already got it. Everybody is his family's already got it. He's cool, though. But Cyro K definitely came back. What is the difference between SAS and Reaction Wheel? Oh, man. Your name makes me think of a Guitar Hero song. I've caught up. All right. All right. Chat beacon. This is a me help desk beacon. Right there, folks. I've got a lot of questions. I've got a lot of questions already logged. I appreciate those great questions. I am now going to start answering some of the questions, flying and or crashing rockets. Scary Fest, Commando Solo, and Noob K. I appreciate y'all. I really do appreciate the support, guys. I really do appreciate the support. People like you let people like me do things like this. Help Desk Bacon, Chunky Chicken TV. Dude, what's up? Yes. Ah, yes. So let's do this. Everybody, time out. We're going to listen for a second. We're going to listen for a second. We're going to listen for a second. On my stream, I love to read my chat. I've got a couple different things. I've got a couple different things that I ask people to do so that I can keep reading my chat and answering questions. You'll see that if you say the word DOS or you say the word question, it'll highlight in red. Do not abuse that for me. I'd really appreciate it if you don't abuse that. I really want to be able to read those highlighted questions. I really want to be able to go back and answer those questions for the people that ask them. Please do not abuse the highlighting. Don't put a bunch of trolley stuff in there. My mods will take care of it if you do. And please don't repeat your question. So if you ask a question, it gets highlighted in red. It gets logged. I've got a huge one entire monitor over here. 27 inches of question logging capabilities. That's what's going on over here. Please don't ask your question over and over and over again. If you do that, and the mods ask you not to, and you keep doing that, not only will I probably not answer your question, you'll probably get timed out a little bit. it's really just so that I can keep the highlighting on there. The highlighting is so important to me, being able to answer your questions, that sort of stuff. That is my stream. That is my stream. And I gotta protect my ability to do my stream. So I do appreciate y'all so much. Also, Kerbal Space Academy family friendly. We've got a lot of families. We've got a lot of kids that watch with their families who have given them consent to watch because they're being supervised while they're watching. COVID 2000 hype. Anyways, so please keep it classy in my streams. Watch your language. If you wouldn't have the conversation with the kindergartner, please don't have it. I love getting people excited about space. I think that kids need to get excited about space. I think that they need to not worry about their iPhones and their clothes and whatever it is that kids worry about these days. I think they need to get excited about space and science and technology, because that's how we get cool things like new iPhones and Mars missions and new technologies to save starving people in Africa. We need to focus on that stuff, and we need people to be excited about it. So keep it family friendly. Watch the language. Not my mods will click on you. It's pretty easy. Moving right along, let me begin answering questions. Oh, look at this. Our first catch of the day. Our first catch of the day. That was easy. That was easy. Thanks, I've got it. Let's start answering some questions here. You see how easy that was? I didn't even have to slow down. Our first catch of the day. Help desk questions. What is today, 2014? Oh, 12 or 12, 19. Man, it's beginning to feel a lot like Christmas. I've saved it. All right. Oh, yeah, Kamuchi. Wow, that's actually going to be difficult. I've already gone way past it. All right. Let me start going through my questions. I may not pause the chat at first. Let me see what I've got here. What's the best orbiter to upgrade the KSC buildings? Polomius, I think I've answered that one. I said upgrade that pad first because that 18 tons is a killer. A close second may be the mission control of this building right here. That'll allow you to go from 2 to 7 missions. Yes. Wrong drink. That's okay. That'll allow you to go from 2 to 7 missions. Maybe you could upgrade mission control first to get more missions to lock in. It's really hard to do missions on 18 tons, so it would be maybe a toss-up between mission control and launch pad. Mission control and launch pad. Those are the first things that I would get upgraded, though. Then I would probably go to the VAB. I would probably go to the VAB because that 30 part count is a killer. So I've got that one. Excellent question. Polonius MBT game. How to use the suicide burn calculator. Okay. Making planes. We had a couple things on planes. Okay. Interplanetary transfer. Okay. Kerbal alarm clock. I'll do that for you. There's the thing on that. I'm putting together the remission in my head so I can answer some of these questions here. Hey, Doss, can you explain Delta V today? Yes. Multi-fueling tanks off one. All right, folks. I am going to start with the space plane questions. I'm going to do a very, very, very quick intro to planes. Excuse me. I'm going to do a very quick intro to planes. Because I've got three people that were asking about planes. So let's look at planes right quick. Let's look at planes. And honestly, right now, guys, if you're asking questions right now, you may want to stop asking questions until I add in, because I've got 12 questions over here that I'm going to answer before I start answering new questions. So let me do this. Let me go over here. I'm going to go into here. This is a space plane hangar. That's where you build space planes, as it turns out. And let me go over the basics of planes very quickly. I'm going to build a very simple plane here. Just a very simple plane. Stream's good. All right, good deal. So with a plane, one of the most important things with a plane is the center of lift versus the center of mass. What does that mean? You've got one bit of force acting on your craft, which is the lift of the wings or whatever lifting bodies you have available that pick it up into the air. You've got another force acting on your craft, which is the gravity pulling you down. Let's see here. Where is the little fuel tank? There we go. So I'm going to put a fuel tank on there. I'm just going to put a basic jet engine on there. Actually, let's put 2 fuel tanks just to make it a little bit different. Let's go like that. I'm not building a space plane. I'm just talking to you about basics of plane balance here. I'm going to come over here, and I'm going to grab this delta wing, and I'm going to toss the delta wings on there. Like that. I'll toss me a little tail on there. That should be okay. That's actually not very good looking because that's huge. Why is that so huge? Did that get bigger? Let's just toss that guy on there. Alright, so now we've got a very, very, very basic plane, don't we? It's going to need a couple landing gear, and then we should be good to go. Ah, it's going to need landing gear and one other thing. Engines, as it turns out, need intake air. So you're going to have some capability to intake air into the engine, ingest air into the engine. That one right there has an air intake. You can see it on the top. Let me toss some wheels on here, and then we will talk about center of lift versus center of mass. We've got these little gear bearings. They're excellent. Okay. I'm going to put those there. I'm going to go like that. That may or may not be too far back. I'm not sure. I'll put this gear up in the front, and then we will talk to you about why your planes always have problems. That is not looking too bad, I guess. That's not looking too bad. It looks kind of bad, but it's not looking too bad. So we've got a very, very, very basic plane. It's missing control surfaces, so let me just toss a quick little control surface on. Like that. Can I put one of these? Will this match? It's very interesting. Other way around. Come on, Das. How many directions are there? Seriously? 2x symmetry would be nice. And there we go. So we have a very, very, very basic plane here. We have a very, very, very basic plane. Looks eerily like the Aeris. You're right. I just threw it together really quickly. We have a very basic plane. Now, a lot of you would be tempted to just run this thing out to the runway and fly it. I know that if I do, it's going to fly fine. But a lot of you would be tempted to run out to the runway and just start flying it. Don't do that. I implore you, don't do that. Before you do that, come down here. Do you see the little highlight that says center of mass? Click on it. That shows you where the center of mass of the plane is. Do you see this one right here that has a little wing? Click on that. That's going to show you the center of lift. Do you see what this has given me? It's given me two indicators on the screen that show me where the center of mass and the center of lift are. Now, I've apparently built the plane fine from the get-go, but you can see as I were to, say, move these wings around, do you see how the center of mass changes and the center of lift changes? That is very important for the performance of your craft. Typically, you're going to want your center of lift to be just behind the center of mass like that. You're going to want it to be just like that. A lot of people always ask, they're like, Das, man, why don't you just put it right on the center of mass? The trick with planes is that you want them to be stable in some direction. And if you have the center of lift directly on the center of mass, it's not stable. The plane will be very, very maneuverable, but it will also like to flip out in all sorts of different directions if you put it right there. What you really want is like you used to do with your paper airplanes. If you put your center of mass or center of lift a little bit behind it, the plane will try to fall in one direction. Constantly fall in one direction. That's going to make it inherently stable. That's a very important concept for planes. Inherent stability is very important. So putting my center of lift behind my center of mass like this is going to make the center of lift constantly pick up the back of the center of mass, pick up the back of the plane. It's going to make it constantly try to kind of go forward, which you can easily correct with your ailerons. That is what we're going to want to do there. So I'm going to put it right like that. I am going to do this here, and let's take it out to the runway and fly it right quick. Let's go fly it right quick and see if I'm right. The KSP keys would be great. Thank you. Where are the KSP keys? There you are. Excellent. Thank you. Good catch. So I'm just going to go ahead and throttle up, panel lock. Look at that. Isn't that cool? I love it. And it's got the natural log. It needs that in there for sure. Excellent. That's so freaking cool. Thank you. Right car. So let's just go ahead and light the engine here. That is going to do this. We are going to start going down the runway. We're going mostly straight, which is important. I should be able to pull up off the runway. I should be able to put my gear down. And I should be able to do a totally sweet spin. Like that. Because we looked at it in the VAB, this plane is inherently stable. Look at what it's doing. I've got my arm resting on a pizza box. Here, just a second. I need a timeout. Okay. I've got my arm resting on a pizza box, and it's a little hard to press the keys, honestly. That right there plane flies perfectly fine. I'm cheating a little bit. I'm using SAS. I am using the SAS. But you can see, if I turn off the SAS, remember the center of lift was behind the center of mass? That gives it a little bit of a lever arm. A little bit of a lever arm is going to pull the back of the craft up because the center of mass has the force of the lift acting behind it, so it's going to pull it up like that. Watch what happens if I turn off SAS. Watch this. I'm going to let go of SAS. Do you see how it's constantly kind of nosing down? That right there is because the center of mass is, or center of mass is in front of the center of lift. That is what we're seeing there. The good news is it's really easy for me to compensate. It's really easy for me to compensate. In fact, if I just turn on SAS, the craft will fly perfectly straight and narrow. That is exactly what I want. Look at all these things. That's awesome. / Jebediah Kerman. I wonder what would happen if I just told him to point retrograde all of a sudden. He can't. He can't point retrograde. It doesn't work that way. It doesn't work that way. Anyways, those are some good questions about the plane. I was doing a very basic intro to planes. I don't think I'm going to spend the time on this. I will tell you one more thing. Let's go back and talk about another important thing about the space planes. Alphabet Gamer, what's going on? Guys, I am not reading chat right now. I'm answering the questions that I've already got. Also, I'm going to get some pizza. I'm totally going to eat a piece of pizza. A very important thing here with the planes and the taking of the offs, right? Being able to rotate up, get your nose up in the air so you start to go into the air instead of into the sea, which is what's at the end of the runway, is the orientation of your landing gear. I saw this question come through. This landing gear oriented, where it's placed in relation to the center of mass. So you can see the center of mass is right there. If I were to put these landing gear in front of the center of mass, not only is it going to look ridiculous, angle snap off, there you go. Not only is that going to, or maybe just right on the center of mass. Let's try that. Right on the center of mass. Not only does that plane look ridiculous, if I launch it, I'm probably going to not have a good time. Watch what's going on. Ah, yes. Michelle, now I have a problem. Didn't rotate the engines. Flip towards the center of mass. Ooh, Jack Minecraft Live. You need to watch my Kerbal Space Academy stream from KSPTV on Monday. I taught people how to balance shuttles. Do you see the problem here? With the landing gear right there on the center of mass, we're actually going to tip backwards. That's not really a recipe for success. Of course, I could fix it just by turning the engine on. That's sweet. That'll push the nose down. So it's got that going for it. But we should be able to take off just fine. Yep, we should be able to land just fine. Probably not. Oh, I bounced. So I've got that going for me. I'm not actually trying to land. Oh my goodness. Wait, motorcycle mode. No, we lost our motorcycle wheel. Is everybody awake now? Let's revert the flight. So putting it too far to the front will make your plane tip backwards. However, putting it too far to the back is going to be a problem as well. Max Fixio, I upload these to YouTube. The trick is you won't be able to ask me questions live on YouTube. What if I put these wheels way in the back? What if I did that? And then I use the offset tool. Something is wrong. I use the offset tool to pull them way back like that. Wilbur, that looks terrible. But let's try to launch it like this, right? Let's try to launch it like this. That let me know exactly what I need to know to build more stable planes. Dude, Yeti, have fun with it, man. Have fun with it. So look how stable that is. Clearly, we're not going to tilt backwards. Let's see if we can take off. I'm going to throttle up, panel lock, SAS engage, 3, 2, 1, space. Now, honestly, with this plane, I'll probably be able to take off. If this plane was a lot heavier and had a much lower lift to weight ratio, this is going to make it a lot more difficult for the plane to rotate up. Oh, maybe I won't be able to rotate up. There, yeah, okay, I can't. Good. Do you see how now I'm giving it S? I'm giving it the S key and it is not taking off? The plane, the landing gear, were so far back that it was preventing me from picking up the mass of the plane. That lever arm so far to the near rear of the plane like that was not a recipe for success. I couldn't actually take it off. Plane has plenty of lift. Plane is fine. It flies just fine. It just couldn't lift up the mass off the runway using the control authority it had. That is what that was. So the moral of the story is, don't put your landing gear too far forward. Don't put your landing gear too far back. You want them to be Goldilocks landing gear. You want them to be just right. Just right. And usually just right looks like this. Just right usually looks like this right here. If you take these guys and you put them in 2x symmetry, and you look at your center of mass, and you get them just a little bit behind your center of mass like that, that is going to keep you from tilting over, but not prevent you from rotating up whenever you're trying to take off. That is exactly what we're trying to take off. excuse me. All right. Good deal. Swept forward wings. Mandalorian, I've got a whole queue of questions to answer right now, so I've done the space plane one for now. I can totally do a space place. Goldilocks landing gear, yeah. I can totally do a space plane stream where I spend a couple hours building a plane with swept forward wings. That would actually be really cool to do. That is not a bad idea. I know there may have been some ancillary follow-up questions or anything like that, but thank y'all so much. That was a really great question, and that was for Yeti, and Sleepy Hipster Space Travel, and hopefully your family that's watching with you, Sleepy Hipster. That was y'all's questions about planes. Hemispheric flight. That stability is what you want. Any chance of working simple plane model? Nelligan. I've got one of those. Right now. If you go to Craft, look at the KSA space plane trainer, and you'll have a space plane capable or a space capable plane that you can play around with that I built during a stream that follows all of these guidelines. You can actually watch the video on YouTube where I built that space plane trainer. Go over to KerbalX Space Academy/Craft. Get my space plane trainer. Play with it. You can watch the video on YouTube. You'll see intro to space planes. That's where I built the space plane trainer. That's what you should be looking for. That would be a great thing there. Moving right along, folks. I got more questions. I think I answered some good questions, so let me take a bite of pizza right quick. I have been missing so much stuff. Ghost Guard, SMP Post, or SM Post, Alpha Beta Gamer. Guys, thank you for enrolling in Kerbal Space Academy. I appreciate you attending the help desk. Extros Gamer, TNT Trisket. That's funny. L30 Sage, Konavon, Wacky Tech. Complete X-Snips and ARK, with lots of X's around your name. Guys, thanks for hanging out with us. I am answering questions right now. StockCraft, blasphemy. They teach you important lessons in what not to do. All right, folks. I have earned a piece of pizza. So let me eat a piece of pizza. Casper, if you're out there, now's the time to watch, because I'm going to eat on the camera for you. I think answering those questions has earned a piece of pizza. And next, I will be looking at Kerbal Alarm Clock and Suicide Burns. So coming up next is Kerbal Alarm Clock, Suicide Burns. That's T-Game's question, LarryJ87's question. Red Tango, we can do you as well. There we go, because you were asking about gaining experience. Delta V, Smooth, I may be able to do that one in the same mission. We're going to toss together a mission to knock out four questions at once, I believe. Alright, I think I get that. I'm looking here, I'm seeing if I missed anything else. Oh, good close rate for Listoff. And Radium Skull, I can get you as well. Ah, I'm going to answer six questions with one cup right here. Suicide Burns may meet explosions, you're right. But for now, hey, yeah, if you want to play along, if your computer can handle it, open up KSP, or if you don't even have KSP, open up the demo in another window. Play around and ask me questions based on that stuff. Do it. Go for it. This is the, what is this? This is the plane demonstrator. Plane demonstrator. The KSA plane demonstrator. That's fine. Save it. I'm going to leave it on the screen. I'm going to eat a piece of pizza, then I'm going to come on with this mission. T-Game, Larry J, Red Tango, Smooth, 7-Eleven, Ride Card, Nate H, and Radium Skull. That's seven questions. Seven questions I will be answering with the next mission here. But first, I require pizza. Mafixio, go now. Because I'm eating a piece of pizza. Guys, I can't keep up with the chat as much. I logged some questions. I'm going to eat some pizza while I scroll through the chat here. And I do appreciate everybody being here. How we doing, by the way? I'm curious. Excelente. Good deal. All right. We've got that. Move my what? Move your coordinates. You went Starscream. Oh! There we go. Okay, I like it. A pizza mod. Yeah, guys, I'm going to take a two-second break. I'm going to eat me a piece of pizza while I read some chat that I missed and see what I got. Did we give Quetzi some love? I see all sorts of moo cows in my channel. All right. Oh, wow, I'm all the way back up here. I'm good to deal. Did I get anything else? All right, there we go. Good to deal. What would you like to see in the new Aero model coming up, huh? I would really like to see, I don't know if I'm worried about the Aero model. It'd be nice if Nose Cones did something. I don't want it to be too complicated, though. I don't want it to be too complicated. I see how they could make the aerodynamic model too complicated and turn off new players. Or at least have it, like, toggleable or something like that. Yes, Radium Skull. I am going to go through the chat and ask questions. Yeah, if I go past a question, what I'm doing... So everybody understands, if I read the chat and I see your question and I say it out loud, I'm usually going to put it over in a little text pad where I log on my questions and then I'll go back and answer it. That's what I usually do. Ark. Someone who will answer questions. That's me, man. Welcome to Kerbal Space Academy. Why can't I complete the Separon 1 decoupler contract? It has checks on flying and landed? How does it have checks on flying and landed? You can't be flying and landed at the same time. Are they two different contracts? Give me some more information. Or post up a screenshot of what your contract is. Laughing Man. Are any tips for building a plane that doesn't wobble like crazy? Building a plane or building a rocket? Laughing Man, I just talked about planes. Building a rocket, you probably just need more launch clamps. What's the difference between a figure 8 orbit, like the Apollo 8 one, and a 6S one? A 6S shaped one? I don't understand your question. I don't understand your question, L30 Sag there. The figure 8 is like a free return, or not necessarily a free return, but it's just you go around the moon, then you come back. The 6S-shaped one, I'm honestly not aware of what that is. I totally post up a link if you've got a link to what that orbit is or something like that. Jack's Hammer, upgrading makes the buildings better. Is it worth it to get a proper joystick? Probably. I don't know, I don't have one. I don't have a joystick. Cap Sierra. What's your advice for large payload carrying VTOL SSTOs? Don't do that. Why would you do that? That would be an entire stream to answer that one. I'm gonna do it though. I'm gonna do it. Next week sometime probably. Mandalorian is not impossible. It's just not efficient in real life to reach orbit with one stage. We got the keys. I am eating, guys. It's not Space Plane Day. I'm doing help desk. And Silas, welcome, by the way. I'm just answering planes. Or I'm answering questions about all sorts of stuff. Sanchez, I got your back. Doesn't matter where you put the wheels. Is it possible to have a flame plane fly straight without SAS? Yes, but you probably don't want that to happen because that means that it would be neutrally balanced, neutrally stable, I guess, which means not stable, really. So you could get it to fly, but every time you tried to maneuver it, it would go like crazy. That'd be a huge problem. All bad. I can definitely teach you the symbols. All right, I think I'm getting caught up here. I think I am getting caught up. I remember seeing these questions. You just got to KSPTV when it ended. Nice. There's the upload. Excellent. Why aren't am I not working for questions right now? You can do flaps, Vic Jess. You can do flaps. You can't do air brakes or anything like that, but you can do flaps. I'm not a rocket scientist. Is moving the wings with offset effects... Oh, Thilo! Dude, that is a great question we need to answer right now. Oh my gosh, Does moving the wings with offset change the center of lift? I don't know. That's a great question. Let's look. There's the center of lift. Let's use the offset tool. Yes. Moving the wings with the offset tool does change the center of lift. That actually makes it a lot easier to move the wings around as well. So yes, using the offset tool just changed. That was a great question. Why would we not be hanging out with you? It's not like we have anything better to do. Enjoy. No, the space plane could not do it. The space plane could not reach orbit because it has no rocket engines on it. It only has air breathing engines. And once I get to orbit, I couldn't circularize because I'd have no way to move the craft. Besides getting out and pushing. Alright, I think the cord is fixed. Dean Y3, that's a great one. The Astronaut Complex is a cheap upgrade that allows for more science because you can get surface samples. That's a great one. Or you could just use engineers. That was EVAs, actually. That was EVAs, I mean. Sorry. Engineers can do, or scientists can do surface samples. My bad. Yeah. There we go. I got the headphones. Lyric and Waffle need to watch your stream. Tell them. Tell them, Sanchez. Got an order for the first time. Okay. All right, guys. I'm good to go. I have done all that. I've got caught up. Let me eat another couple pieces of pizza. We're going to go over to the VAB, and we're going to start answering the next questions about suicide burns, about a Kerbal Alarm Clock. I need to stop doing that. About suicide burns, about Kerbal Alarm Clock, about experience, about Delta V, about... I can't do interplanetary transfer right now. Huh. About thrust to weight, and then about SAS reaction wheels. So let's go over to the VAB. I do need to stop doing that. I'm trying to do better. Let's go to the VAB. That's important. It's only bad if you show the back of your hand. Okay, good deal. I didn't know that. Thank you, Mike Mayoko. I appreciate you. Guys, there are a lot of questions comes in, but I am talking... excuse me. I am talking now about a suicide burn. I'm designing a craft that will be good for suicide burn. This is delicious. Spartan bot boot up sequence activated. What's going on? Almost done here. Then we're going to build this rocket and do a suicide burn on the moon. Pizza. Delicious pizza. I've already done that, enjoy. Look for orbital construction. All right. I have successfully earned my first piece of pizza by answering questions. Good time. You can't have any questions. Peace, boy. Sorry. Nope. Can't have any questions. So, I'm going to talk about... I'm going to choke to death. Silas. Merry Christmas, Doss. Your community loves you, my friend. Keep doing what you're doing. Eating pizza? Okay. I will totally do that. Oh, my gosh. Thank you, Silas. I appreciate you. I really do appreciate you. That is, I mean, you donated a copy of the game. And another copy of the game. You donate so much stuff to me, man. I really do appreciate you. I really do. Gosh. You're awesome. That's all I can say. You're awesome. Koniger TV. I missed some follows. Let me grab my quick. Koniger TV. Rosie Coldness. Mike Hunte. Pancake. Ghost Guard. S&P post, okay, I think I'm all caught up. Excellent. Guys, thanks for the follows. Welcome to the help desk. In career mode, the first slice of pizza is unlocked after 10 questions. Cap Sierra, I agree. I don't know about the numbers, but Alt and Shift would be good. So, I try hardest. Welcome. All right, guys. I'm going to stop answering new questions that are coming in, and let's talk about this. Some other people can answer questions for you in chat if you're asking them. I'm going to focus on the questions that came in at the beginning of the stream. So that is what I'm going to do here. I've got a craft. And the question was about suicide burns. If you don't know what a suicide burn is where you're falling towards the surface of something that you don't want to crash into, and you don't light the engines to the last possible second, such that the deceleration that you get from your engines brings you to a stop the instant you touch the ground. That's a suicide burn. It's a very efficient way to do things, because it gives gravity very, very, very little time to act on your craft. You're falling towards the surface of the planet. You're not hovering at all. You're like, yeah, let's get there. You get there as fast as you can. At the last possible second, you light the engines and you come to a stop. You come to a stop right at the surface of the planet. It's a very tricky maneuver to master. But let's see what we can do about it. I'm just going to make a very simple mooner craft here. Let's see if we can do this. I'm not going to get experience in this mode. I can't answer questions about experience. Dang it. Okay, that's okay. Let's do this just very quickly here. That's why that's tucked in, isn't it? I never knew that. That's why that pod is offset. That's why the pod doesn't look good with anything except a decoupler. Interesting. yeah, Cap Sierra, I'd rather point at them and show you where they are than just press a button. It's probably more discoverable, probably learn more if you see my mouse go up there than just, you know what I mean? So, the suicide burn. The most important thing for a suicide burn is a lot of thrust to weight. I need more thrust to weight than I can have. I can't have 1.0 thrust to weight. That would be a recipe for disaster. I need to have a lot of extra thrust in this craft. So this right here is going to look really good for me. I've got a thrust to weight of 8.44 on the moon. If you didn't see what I was doing when I was chomping on that pizza, I actually expanded Kerbal Engineer. I changed the body to the moon. There, let me turn that down a little bit. I changed the body to the moon. That put my thrust to weight relative to the moon's local gravity instead of Kerbin's local gravity. This means that I would be able to take off the moon 8x. I've got over eight times the thrust that I need in order to take off the moon. That's going to mean that I'm going to be able to decelerate very, 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 very quickly. I want to be able to decelerate very quickly, and I want to be able to do so without crashing into the surface. I want a little bit extra padding in there from a thrust perspective in case I need to bump it up if I'm going to hit the surface. So that's important. Let me toss the rest of this craft together right quick. The suicide burning starts with craft design. If you design a craft that does not have the capabilities to do the suicide burn, like if you try to do some shenanigany nonsense like this, you put these little engine for ants on here, and you thought that two of those was going to get you a suicide burn done, well, you could probably still do a suicide burn. That thrust of weight is 1.49, really? That's amazing. Is that on the moon? How much thrust do those things put out? Four? Wow, I could take off from the moon like that? That would actually be an insanely interesting experiment. I'm taking both. I'm going to see if I can do a suicide burn with those little engines. That's actually really cool. Oh no, Halo Killer, don't be aggravated. Don't be aggravated by my video, dude. Halo Killer, thank you again for that awesome video. There we go. Let's put... Oh, dorsal balcony. There you go. Dorsal balcony, excellent. Let's do this. We're also going to want some landing gear on here. So let's toss some of these landing gear on here. Make sure that you have enough clearance so that your landing gear can compress without destroying your engine. You may hit a little hard when you're doing a suicide burn. Honestly, you're either going to die or you're going to land perfectly. So just make sure that you have enough clearance on those compression, the shock absorbers and the landing gear. Make sure that that's the hap. Ruin the little one's thrust to weight. That's a good question. Let's check it. We can check that. That's actually a great thing. Let's see here. The thrust weight in this mode will be 7.7. The thrust weight in this mode will be 1.24, so we're still good. 7.7 and 1.24. We're still good. It brought it down quite a bit. That was a great observation, but we're not going to have to worry about it. The suicide burn is dangerous. The suicide burn is dangerous. So I wouldn't recommend it all the time, but it is more efficient. You should end up with more Delta V left over. Let's put the light on there. I'm also going to put this light on here. This is just a thing that I do. There we go. That all looks good. Anything else? I'm just going to slap a solar panel on, then we're going to call it good enough for government work and get it to the moon. Where is a solar panel? There you go. Good enough. Good enough. So let's just put it on here. Like this. All right, excellent. The light from the battery will consistently charge your solar panels. This is a great way to ensure that you'll never run out of electricity, because the light coming out of this battery will actually help you get some... I lie. That doesn't work at all. Infinite energy! I'm going to be rich. All right, so we've got that. That's more than enough to land and get us home. It's a very sensible... Oh, everybody needs to know what the temperature is in space from a fashion perspective. So let's slap that on there right quick. Perfect. Alright. They have a sale on the Star Citizen ships. I don't even know which one to get. I need to get this to the moon, so let's talk about it right quick. We know from the Delta V chart that a lunar transfer and a lunar orbit is about 1170 Delta V, so I'm going to make a kicker stage that has about 1170 Delta V. That's just 860 plus 210. That is what that was. I know I'm going over this very quickly, guys, but this is Help Desk. I need to get to lots of questions, not go too far in depth on any one question. A kicker stage like that usually looks like this. We can toss this guy in here. Yes, we can do drop tanks. Yes, there are more efficient things to do. 1340, that's a great kicker stage. That is an absolutely great kicker stage right there. A mooner kicker stage is what I should say. That is a great mooner kicker stage. 0.76, 1305, that is fine. That is fine. That's atmospheric as well. Let's get the rest of the rocket into space. We're talking about Delta Vs, and somebody asked me what Delta V was. Delta V is my capability to change my situation in space. Look at that as I design this rocket. My top stage here, this is what's going to allow me to land and take back off and come home. So looking at my image, to land on the moon is going to cost me 640. To take back off from the moon again is going to cost me another 640. That's from low moon orbit back. So I need at least 1200 in the lander just to take off and then land and then take back off again. Bump that margin up. If you're not very good at landings, if you're learning, if you just want a safety factor, bump that margin up. That's why I'm carrying what? I'm carrying how much Delta Vs? 2,000, 2,500 Delta V, even though it says it should only be 1280. Bump the margin up so you have some error, you have some room for error in there. The other stage, I said it needed 1170. To go from low Kerbin orbit, the situation low Kerbin orbit, out to low moon orbit is going to cost me 860 plus 210. That's why the kicker stage, this guy right here that's going to kick me over to the moon, needs to have at least 1070 Delta V. That's atmospheric mode. There you go. It's got 1346 and I needed 1070. So again, I've built in a little bit of extra room for error. I needed 860 plus 210. I've got 1346 in the kicker stage. That's great. That's room for error in case something goes wrong, in case I do it wrong, in case there's a trolley moon in my way, whatever it is, building in room for error is very important. My next thing, I need to get into orbit. I need to know how much Delta V it takes me to go from landed on Kerbin to low Kerbin orbit. I can look at that like this. It's going to be 4550. I know from experience that if I make the number in Kerbal Engineer say 4,000, that will get me into orbit. So let me minimize this right quick, and then I'll circle back and I'll show you that. We've already got that. Let's toss this together. I'm going to do my standard lifter kicker design. It's just easy to throw together without thinking about it. My kicker to get me into orbit, my orbital kicker, needs to have 1.5 thrust to weight and 1,500 Delta V. That's 1.5 and 1361. That's perfect. My lifter stage that gets me off the launch pad. Why are these parts in such a weird order now? I don't know why the parts are in that order. It doesn't really make a lot of sense to me. My lifter stage is going to need to have 1.7 thrust to weight in 2,500 Delta V. If you're interested in how I came up with those numbers, come to boot camp tomorrow and I'll show you. But let me toss these guys on here right quick. That is that. Let's put these on. That is good. Let's get another one. Actually, we could use the bigger engines, couldn't we? There we go. How's that looking? 1.96, 2154. If I've got more thrust to weight than 1.7 and I have less delta V, I atmospheric mundus. That one needs a little bit more fuel in here. I didn't have it in atmospheric mode. It needs to, like, start whining at me. It does. Cybertech's awesome. There we go. 1.5 and 13.9, so 1,400. That's a good kicker. 1.9 and 1,784. This needs more. This needs more. I think I may just go with four of these down here. Hey. That's interesting. Why can't I change my symmetry? There we go. 2.11, 2046. All right. And then we can do this. Oh. I didn't have the middle engine lit. That's what happened. This is very interesting. The game is not responding to me for some reason. I don't know why I can't click on parts, but that's actually very weird. That is not something we're used to in 0.90. Okay. I don't know what's going on there, but it's acting a little bit wobbly. Let me put that engine down there. 2.49. That means we can put a lot more fuel in these outer tanks. 3,000 delta V. That's too much fuel, so we'll just put the smaller tanks like this. Ah, that's perfect. It's not exactly right, but this'll do. This'll do right here. Because I need to run fuel lines in like that. 3415, 2.27 on the pad. Ah, there's the problem. Now we can put the bigger tanks there. 3624, 1.46, 2.08, we can put even more fuel in. And I am trying to balance this out. I don't want all the fuel on the top or the bottom or anything like that. 3813, that's getting us closer. We can add a little bit more fuel. If we do this, I bet you it's going to be perfect. 4113, that's too much fuel. Again, I'm just tuning my rocket here. That plus this should probably be perfect. 3985. So what did I say? 1.79 on the pad, I wanted 1.7. 2,500 meters per second of delta V, I wanted that. 2,587 is fine. 1.5 thrust weight in the kicker. 1,398, a total there of 4,000. 3,985 is good enough for government work. Solid rocket boosters, no, Fred Graven. I'm not worried about the efficiency of the rocket, I'm just worried about getting it into space right now. I'm just worried about getting it into space, so I'm not going to try to go into solid fuel versus this, versus that, versus the other. This is the easiest way to design a rocket you know will work. This is the easiest way to design a rocket you know will work. And I'm doing that. It is more efficient, it can be cheaper, all that sort of stuff if you use the solid fuel boosters, but that's not what I'm looking for right now. I am looking for a rocket that will work. Let me toss these on. The little separatrons will help kick it away. Is that even? It looks like it. Alright, now I'm going to do the staging. And guys, I know I've missed a lot of questions in chat. I am working on this. I will scroll back through the chat and answer questions. That right there is a great looking moon rocket, honestly. It really does look like a good moon rocket. We could make it a little bit more stable if we wanted to do this. If we wanted to go from there up to that, that'll be good. I put it on the engine. I probably don't like doing that. All right, is that all with Kerbal Engineer or still the moon? I do believe I switched it back to Kerbin. Good catch. Did I miss anything? There's the cheat sheet. More boosters. Can you complete the back SAB mission? Yes, we've done that. Perpetual motion sheet. All right, good deal. I haven't missed too many questions. So this right here is a great lunar rocket that should be capable of a suicide burn. Bottom stage, light all engines. Good. Also release the launch clamps. Good. When we decouple the side stages, I'm also going to want these separatrons to fire. I know you can't see that, but let's just get through it. That goes there. That goes there. We have those in a separate stage. Then we have this. Then we have that. That's the one bane of having my chat on the side of the screen, but we should be good. Can you click the eye so we can see the stats? Sure, said Fred Graven. That's 49.5 tons with 63 parts. So in order to build this rocket, you would have to both upgrade the VAB and the launch pad in career mode. You'd have to upgrade the VAB and the launch pad. The VAB because of the part count. Stage 1 VAB, you're only limited to 30. The mass, or the launch pad, because of the mass, you're limited to 18. So that is what we're going to do there. But that's okay, that's okay. Let's get this thing out here. I've explained Delta V. For smooth 7-Eleven, I've explained Delta V. I have talked about Nate H. What's a good thrust weight on lift point one on liftoff? 1.7 in stock aerodynamics. Nate H. 1.7 in stock aerodynamics. Right click on it to upgrade a JJ owner. 1.7 is what you want. That's fire and forget. If you go full throttle and you have 1.7, according to engineer, you can just leave it full throttle all the way up to 10K, and you won't really exceed the atmospheric efficiency boundaries very differently, very difficultly. Radium Skull. Radium Skull, I'm going to come back to your question. I hope you're here, I hope you're still here. What's the difference between SAS and a reaction wheel? SAS is stability augmentation system. I don't need to come back to that one. Stability augmentation system helps you continue to keep the rocket pointed in whatever direction that you're going using whatever control authority it has, be that flaps, be that engine gimbals, be that reaction wheels, or be that RCS, the actual RCS fuel system. The reaction wheel itself is a way that you can orient the craft in space using pitch, yaw, and roll without using fuel. It's electrically powered. It's a big wheel that spins, and if you spin the wheel up, you can turn yourself in one direction. And if you break the wheel, if you slow the wheel down, you can spin yourself in the other direction. That's what a reaction wheel is. We could get a great Wikipedia article on those, I think. We could get a great Wikipedia article. So this is going to be Mooner Suicider. This is the KSA Mooner Suicider. I'm going to go ahead and save it. Can I get my flag now? I still can't get my flag. I have to reload the database. Let's just launch it. I wish I could put a named Kerbal in here. Phoenix, that's great. SAS is computer logic or the pilot's intuition, the pilot's abilities, and the mechanism, the reaction wheel is the mechanism that it can use. That is a great explanation. That is a greater explanation. Let's launch this thing, folks, and let's crash something. Nice, Nubius. Dude, click it. Click it twice. Order some for yourself as well. Excuse me. We've got old Jebediah in here. That's fine. Let's throttle up. Let's panel lock. Let's SAS engage. Oh, we've got monoprop in the pod. That's okay. We don't need the monoprop. What's the difference between in the delta V for each stage? Oh, Yodafall, the first number is the delta V in that stage. The second number is the total delta V. The first number is the delta V in that stage. The second number is the total delta V. Good question. 3, 2, 1, space. Oh, yeah, no, over here, yeah, in the flight scene, the second number is the burn time of that stage. In the VAB, the second number is the total delta V. Sorry, I didn't know which one you were asking about there. What does a double follow need? I love these things, by the way. I do love these things. Especially since you have to level up a pilot or buy a special probe core to do it. Boy in blue, you've been warned, man. You've been warned by the mods. I said something about it. Please don't repeat your questions over and over. It's just spammy, man. It's just spammy. Okay? I'm really trying to help people out here, but if you keep spamming your question over and over again, just like I tell my kindergartners, if you're the one who's standing up yelling, pick me, pick me, pick me, whenever I need a volunteer, I'm not going to pick you. If you're spamming your questions, just don't do it, man. It's just not cool. It's just not cool. So let's see here. I'm going to go straight up until 10K. I had that 1.7 on the pad, so my launch was good to go the entire time. When I get to 10K, I'm going to point at a 45-degree angle to the east, like this. I'm going to go ahead and start tilting this rocket over. This is my orbital pitch program. And I'm going to tilt over to the east, just like this, until I get to a 45-degree angle. Das, why does it say 90 on the nav ball? It's a heading. It's a bearing of 90 degrees, which is east, at a 45-degree pitch or elevation above the horizon. Do you see how the rocket is at a 45 degree angle to the horizon? This is the horizon, this is 90 degrees straight up noon. This over here is a 45 degree angle. That is what I want to do, and I want to burn right like this until my apoapsis, you see the apoapsis right there? My apoapsis is 50. When my apoapsis gets to be 50, I want to lean over like this. Don't need that anymore. A little wonky. But when my apoapsis gets to 50, I do what's called turn and burn. I make sure that that says orbit. If it says surface, you can click on it to make it say orbit. And then I try to burn down towards the horizon like this. Down towards the horizon like this. And I'm going to burn right like this until I get an apo of about 80. For a Mooner transfer, I'm going to go up to 80. So there's 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, and I'm just burning down and down and down. I don't want to go up a lot. I want to go around a lot. I want to go around the planet. I don't want to go higher above the planet. 79 and 80. That's perfect. Now we can go. Now we can go. Nate H, that's a great question that I'm going to come back to, man. I really do love that question. That's a really great question. That's a really great question. I'm going to come over here and circularize. If I've got this unlocked, I can just click there, add maneuver, and I can pull prograde until I get the periaps over there. That's actually too much. If I click on it, it should stick. No. If I click on it, it should stick. Excellent. Then I can pull this on down until I have about an 80 by 80 orbit. Yeah, that's fine. All right. Oh my gosh, Cybertech. I need Cybertech because that's got to change. That's got to change. Let's see here. Did you describe doing the gravity turn when you only reach 10K or staging very slight changes right at launch? Galactor, we did a stream where for 4 hours, we did different ways of launching. What I just showed you is less than 1% less efficient than an optimal profile. I was able to fly right like that, and I was able to, in terms of a MechJeb computer optimal profile, I was able to get to within 1% of it using that right there. So the long and short of it is, theoretically, is it more efficient? Yes. Realistically, in the game, in terms of the margins that you're working with, it makes no difference. It makes no difference for most rockets. As long as you design them using the method that I said, 1.7, 1.5, 2500, 1500, it's almost just not worth your time unless you're really into the role-playing thing. It is more efficient. Yes, it is more efficient by a very, 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 very slim margin. We did an entire stream where we just guest tested. We were writing numbers down in the notepad. We were testing over and over and over again. And it just doesn't, you don't really get much from flying an exact optimal profile in stock aerodynamics. In stock aerodynamics. That is in stock aerodynamics. If you're using near or far, it's a whole different story. But in stock aerodynamics, which is what I'm running right here, it doesn't make a huge difference. I don't want orbital trash, so I'm going to go ahead and cut that stage when it gets to 20. Like that. Then I'm going to decouple and get out of Dodge. Why did I do that? That's because I don't like orbital trash. Perfect. 79, 70, 71, 72, 72, that's fine. 80 by 75, that's good enough for getting to the moon, y'all. It doesn't have to be rocket science. Did you forget to try it? No, J-Pop, I'm doing that next week. Can you show how to make a plane? I'm going to do that next week, guys. The new Mark III parts, if you're interested in the new three parts, the new Mark III parts, catch me next week. I'm going to be designing craft using the new parts next week. That is on my schedule for next week. Ah, yes. So now that we're in a circular orbit, we need to get to the moon. Did I have any other questions? That one. How did you first interplanetary transfer? Ride car. I'm going to take that one down to another, a fewer thing. So now we just need to go over Kerbal Alarm Clock. Larry J87, I've got a question for you right here. I've got your question right here. Can you go over the Kerbal Alarm Clock? I'm going to go over it in brief here, in brief. First, let me go plan my node to the moon, and then I'll show you how to use the Kerbal Alarm Clock to get that node done. There is the moon. Let me show you how easy it is to get to the moon in KSP. You've got yourself in an 80 by 80-ish orbit, right? Good enough. A mostly circularized orbit. Mostly circularized orbit. Fred Graven, 1.5 in the second stage. And Beetle Bailey Gaming, use the word question. I will answer that right there. I got you, Beetle Bailey. I just saw it pop up. That's a good question. Let's talk about going to the moon. I'm just going to click on my orbit. Now that I'm in a roughly circular orbit, 80 by 75 is fine. 80 by 70 would probably be fine. I'm just going to click right there. I'm going to click just anywhere. It doesn't even matter. Just click anywhere on your orbit and click add maneuver. I then want you to look at the planetary system from the top. Like this. Put your node down at the bottom, make it so you can see the orbit of the moon. I'm scrolling in and out, right? That's all I'm doing. I then want you to pull prograde, the little green circle, until you've got an apoapse that's out there by the moon, like that. Right like that. The apoapse should be around 11,400,000 meters. 11,348 is good enough for an encounter. After you've got something that looks like this, your node down at the bottom, your apoapse up there at the orbit of the moon, look at how easy this is. All you have to do, you see how the center of that node highlights in white? All you gotta do is drag it around and keep dragging it around and keep dragging it around until you get the moon. You see the moon up there? You see me hitting the moon? That right there is me hitting the moon. That is a non-free return trajectory. If I wanted, I bet you I could keep going around here and almost get me a free return trajectory. That's so close. That's not it. A little bit less delta V would give me free return. I don't need to worry about free return. I'm going to suicide burn to the moon. Why don't we just hit the moon? Yeah, there. That was just me hitting the moon. Why am I worrying about a free return trajectory? I just want to hit the moon. Anyways, that's really easy. It's really easy. I just put down the node. Look, I'll do it again right quick. Get to the moon. Step one, find the moon. You can do this too. Find the moon. Click on the moon. Set it as your target. Good deal. Step two, click anywhere in your orbit. Click add maneuver. Step three, pull on this until you've got an apoaps up there near the moon. Pull. Done. All right. Apoaps 11245. That's fine. Step four, zoom in so you can see kind of the back of the orbit. Highlight over the middle. You see how that circle in the middle turns white? And drag until you have your sweet, sweet mooner encounter. That is how easy it is. It really is easy to get to the moon, y'all. It really is easy to get to the moon. Don't let anybody tell you that you can't do it because you're a new player or whatever. You can get to the moon. Now, landing on the moon, it's going to be a different thing. So let's go ahead here. We're going to want to do this burn. The question is, I need to know when to do this burn. Kerbal Alarm Clock, LarryJ87. Here's Kerbal Alarm Clock. There's a mod. There's a great mod called Kerbal Alarm Clock. It wakes you up when you need to be doing maneuvers. It can undo warp when you need to be doing maneuvers. It can do so many things when you need to be doing maneuvers. So what we can do here, I've got Kerbal Alarm Clock up here, right? I can click on Kerbal Alarm Clock, and that will bring up the Kerbal Alarm Clock interface. It's so easy. Since I've already got the node put down, all I have to do is press Add. Kerbal Alarm Clock automatically recognizes that I have a maneuver node. Do you see how this little maneuver node looking thing is selected? It automatically knows when the node is supposed to burn. And all I have to do is click Add Alarm. It will now tell me that the KSA Mooner Suicider has a maneuver node to accomplish in 20 minutes and 42 seconds. All I can do here is fast forward. And as I time warp, you can see that Kerbal Alarm Clock ticking down the time to that. Whenever it gets up to this time, Kerbal Alarm Clock will actually bring me out of time warp automatically. Bring me out of time warp automatically. Viru Plays, what's going on, man? It'll bring me out of time warp automatically. It'll tell me what I need to do. If I'm in a different place, if I'm on a different ship, if I'm in a space station somewhere, whatever it is that I'm doing, I can be on another vessel, and Kerbal Alarm Clock will pop this up right here. It'll allow me to jump this ship. It'll allow me to close the alarm. It'll allow me to do everything I need to burn right now. But I am going to go ahead and burn. Alarm Clock has a lot of other features. You can do it when you get to your apoaps, periaps. You can set an alarm for an ascending or descending node where your orbits cross another target orbit. You can set it for a closest target distance when you get close to something you're trying to rendezvous with. You can set it for an SOI change. If you are missing an SOI, if you're going from Kerbin SOI into the moon's SOI, you can set an alarm for that. If you're going to Duna and you want to be woken up whenever you get to Duna's SOI, Kerbal Alarm Clock can do it. Transfer window, I don't really use that one very much, and I have no clue what this is for. A Kerbal crew, I don't know. Contract alarms, if there's an alarm, wow, I didn't know that was there. That's amazing. If you're in career mode and you have a contract that's going to be out of time, it can set an alarm clock for when the contract is going to be out of time. You can also set the margin. You can say, hey, wake me up 15 minutes before this. Wake me up 1 second before this. Wake me up an hour before this. Whatever it is, Kerbal Alarm Clock is so helpful to make sure that you don't miss those maneuver nodes. I know I've kind of gone over that in brief. I think that should be good. Excellent, I think that should be good. What time is it? 10:06, okay. All right, we're just continuing to do the burn. I am reading chat. Dark Viper, dude, what's going on? This is a silly question. I doubt anyone has asked and answered. Why are the Mark points circular in the Mark 3 parts? And when do we get Mark 4? Dore, it's just the form factor that they have to fit within. The Mark 3 parts are huge. The Mark 3 parts have to be able to fit the big 2.5 meter stacks in them. That's why they're kind of boxy looking. The Mark 2 parts have to fit the littler stacks in them. The 1.75, the 1.25 meter stacks in them. That's why they're kind of sexy looking. They're kind of like aerodynamic looking and that sort of stuff. I'm going to need to do this. Periaps, I'm just going to hit the moon. I am now hitting the moon. And we are well on our way. We are well on our way. So, no operation reaction wheels. What does that mean? Oh, that's a bug. Interesting. It told me that I didn't have any reaction wheels when really I just deleted the node. Very interesting. Okay. Let me do this. What's the easiest planet to get to, return from, that's not Dune or Kerbin? Joule, Dergrosovich. Joule, because it has a huge sphere of influence. It has a huge sphere of influence, so it's pretty easy to get caught by Joule. Ah, yes. Let me scroll through this. I'm going to do the time warp thing. We're going to go to screensaver mode. I'm going to add an alarm clock. Look, let's go to alarm clock again. I want it to add an alarm whenever I do my SOI change. Do you see how I actually did that? I can actually edit some text in here. And I can say, wake me up 5 minutes before the SOI change. So this is going to be the KSA Mooner Suicider SOI. Wake me up 5 minutes in advance. Adam. I'm going to go ahead and time warp. Dark Viper, KSA Help Desk, and Dr. Pepper Hype. Also, it's Friday. Happy holidays, everyone. Dude, Dark Viper, you're always there, man, like clockwork. Every day you're there with the 250 donations, man. I really do appreciate you. I really do appreciate the support. Because it adds up. It adds up like crazy. It really does. Thank you so much, Dark Viper, for the support. This is my job, folks. Answering questions in Kerbal Space Program is my job. And people like Dark Viper, Silas, Scary Fast, Commando Solo, Noob K, Husker 1180, I doubt you're here. I got a donation when I was offline. 4 hours before I started the stream. Husker 1180 sent me $20. I don't even know, man. But Husker, I don't think you're here. But thank you so much for the support. Dark Viper, man, your continued support is always appreciated. That looks good. That's going to give me some time to scroll back through the chat. I'm going to do this. Let's go what we can do here in screensaver mode. That's actually not a bad screensaver right there. Just watch that. If we start to crash on the moon, let me know. I'm going to read chat for a second. Perfect Kerbal Alarm Clock tutorial. Sure, Kinslip. Post it up, man. That's fine. I love supporting things like that. There's so much good content on YouTube and just people that take the time out of their day to put stuff like that on YouTube. I really do appreciate that. So if there's a great Perfect Alarm Clock tutorial, post it up, Kinslip. I'd love it. I've seen that bug with nodes, too. Yeah, it just looks like something that was missed. Dude, Dergrosovich, what's going on, by the way? Mission, Wolfster J. We are doing Kerbal Help Desk. We're answering questions. And we will do a giveaway if I get more than 500 concurrent viewers. Quick Moho lesson. Tanarin, that's a pretty big stream. I think I'm going to need to do a specific stream for that. But I'll put it in my quest, my help desk log, and see if I get to it. I'm not going to say that I'm very confident I get to a Moho mission on this. I will be doing a Moho mission in my hard mode career. Sleepy Hipster Space Travel. Cool. You're welcome, Larry. Dude, you're welcome. If you have any other questions, feel free to ask, man. What's good? Das Veru Play, I remember you coming in. Dark Viper, as well. Also with the donation. There's the Mark II Parts Being Cool by Dore22. Fred Gavin, when you say start with 1.7, I answered this one. The second stage, 1.5. The more thrust weight you have in your second stage, the more efficient it is. You don't need that much, but it's a lot more efficient to have a higher thrust weight. In fact, in the second stage, in the kicker stage, if you have 2.0 or 2.5, that's fine. That's fine. As long as you're going with a 1.7 2500. If you have 3.0 and then 1500, that is fine. That is fine. Space plane parts. Yeah, I'm doing those next week, guys. I'm doing those next week with the new space plane parts. You're doing some subtle designs. I love it. Look at this. This is from Minecraft. I think you've got some problems. Jack Minecraft Live. You need to work on this a little bit. It's not looking too good, honestly. I don't think you went to space with that mission. Thanks for the screenshot, though, man. Did I check what my... Yeah, we still have 2 hours. It's a good way to pick where to put Separatrons. Nate, I'm going to do that one for you because that's such a great question. Galactor, I got you with the gravity turn. It is more efficient and more realistic and required in FAR. If you start your pitch program right when you're off the pad, you do it very, very gently. But in terms of efficiency using stock aerodynamics, it's just more complicated. You could do it. There's nothing wrong with doing it. There's absolutely nothing wrong with doing it. But when I'm doing my streams here, I'm just like fire and forget. I want to teach people the basics way, the basic way to get into space. That's what I'm doing. Splane stream next week. My patience is amazing. Dude, B-Berry, I have too much fun doing this. Father of the year. Infun and Dust, thanks you both. Yodafall, you're welcome. Chuffy, what's going on? There's Pale Rider. Dude, Pale Rider, welcome as well. Feel free to ask your questions about KSP. That's the mission, guys. There's Nubius Maximus ordering parts, so I can't be around more. Dude, Convio, don't worry about it. I hope we got you a following, man. I appreciate you streaming KSP. Red Bull, I know. I usually don't do that, but I had a headache. The eye, I did that for you. I've missed so many follows, I'm going to do them in bulk. Is that all with Kerbal Engineer, or still the moon in Kerbal Engineer? It's all within Kerbal Engineer. Let's see here. Wouldn't it be better to use solid? Okay, I remember that one. I think I'm caught up. I think I'm got caught up. Yeah. Max Fixio. In 5 minutes, I explain more than hours on any other stream. That's what I do, man. The reason I can do this for a living is because I'm teaching people real-world concepts. We're getting excited about important things like technology and space. Even if we're not rocket scientists, we're still excited about it. We want to support it, you know? And I love to answer questions. I love to explain things to people. It's just my particular idiom, I guess. Philo, I think you got the cheat sheet. More boosters. Oh, did I miss anything else? All right, we're all the way back to the... All right, guys, I got caught up. Good deal. What day? A couple days next week, Goldie. Probably starting on Monday. I'm going to do it for a couple days next week. Allow you to ask my really newbie questions. Absolutely. Dude, Cypation? Cypation, ask your newbie questions right now. Ask your newbie questions right now. It's the help desk, man. You can ask me anything. I'm not going to be like, well, did you try to turn it off and turn it off again? And if anybody gives you any trouble or calls you an idiot in my chat, I'm going to click on their name and I'm going to tell them to shut up. Ask your newbie questions, man. If you have questions, ask them for me. How do I determine when my launch window to Duna is? Zunafane, use the launch window planner. Alex Moon KSP. Can we get a link to that? That would be great if we could get Zunafane a link to the launch window planner. Bloodless Hacker, doing great. Cypation, ask your questions, man. If anybody gives you any beef or thinks any less of you because you're not a rocket scientist and you're trying to accomplish something and do something awesome in KSP, I'm going to take care of it personally. I'll try to beat the mods to it. Cybertext Web Image Viewer. Yeah, Cybertext Web Image Viewer is so awesome. Viru plays. Do you know how to edit Twitch videos? Do you know how to do highlights, Viru? Because I'll give you permission. I'll give you permissions to do it so you can highlight it. I'm such an idiot. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Viru plays. I so need to do that. Worthwhile to do survey missions before you can find a fly off space plane. Beetle Bailey Gamey. I'm not sure. I haven't done the survey missions yet. What's the third easiest? The third easiest to get to, return from. You can get to Eve pretty easily. Can't land on it, though, very easily. That's a hard one. Wolfster J. Hey, Doss, can you read your post? Thank you for asking, man. Mission. I answered that one for you. The mission is Kerbal Help Desk and doing a giveaway if we get more than 500 concurrent viewers. Are you familiar with Tac Life Support? Yes, Cantab. I did a stream on KSP TV on Tac Life Support. I have two carbon extractors for full Kerbals, but my oxygen is depleting. I don't know if I can answer that off the top of my head. I'd have to play with it, Cantab. Maybe somebody else could help Cantab off with the Tac Life Support there. All right. They really do. Newbie questions rock. They get you into space in fun times. Heck yeah. Heck yeah. DOS the chat guard. I'm serious. Was the third easiest. Yeah, I missed that one, Dear Gross of Fitch. You can get to Eve. All right, guys, let's keep on going. Let's go to the suicide burn here. I should be... Yeah, excellent. We've crossed into the moon's SOI. There's the moon. That was perfect timing. I love it. We are going to the moon. That's where we're going. Look at that sweet screenshot. Isn't that great? Let me do my followers right quick. Set a sock. Three-step rush. Little Galaxy, Sandman with an X in front of a DJ Charger, Vernastrike, Clonadine, Heraun, or no, Heraun, I guess. I'm going to go with Heraun there. Nightwolf 029, Psycho Squirrel, like the spelling there. I used to be Wacky Wabbit, the Camp Psychotic when I was in Boy Scouts. I don't know why they called me that, but that's what they called me that. Maybe it's just because I talk so fast. Zai as well. Guys, thanks for the follows. I do appreciate you. So let's see here. We need to do a suicide burn. In order to do a suicide burn, I need to configure Kerbal Engineer to show me the suicide burn. Let me teach you how to do that. I can actually click on Kerbal Engineer up here, and I can do New Custom Section. New Custom Section. That allows me to make a new custom section called Suicide Calc. I can name it whatever I want right there. I'm not going to put a shortcut there. What does that shortcut do? The shortcut name is what makes it appear whenever I have it over here. If I don't, here, let me see you. SuiteCalc. Like that, okay? Let's just install something. If I open up Engineer, do you see this SuiteCalc right here? If I edit this custom section and I take that out, that makes it disappear from there. That's what gives you a quick launch button like that. That is what that little one is. This is the name of the full window that'll appear right here. SuiteCalc, see? I'm going to make it a HUD. So I'm going to click on HUD like that. Background. Huh, I don't know what that is. I'm going to put some things that I need on it. I don't believe that it's orbital. Let's go see here. Yeah, this is all the maneuver node stuff. So I don't need that. What I'm going to do is go to surface, I believe. So I can click on category surface. Clicking on category surface gives me new things. I would love to see my... Nope, that's not where Suicide Burn is either. Is it going to be under vessel? Yes, it's under vessel. Okay, it's not under surface. It's under vessel. And I am going to see if I can remember this off the top of my head here. Here is my Suicide Burn altitude. Here's my Suicide Burn distance. Here's my Suicide Burn delta V. So let's put those three things on there. And I just did that wrong, didn't I? Yeah, intake air. I didn't want that. I wanted the Suicide Burn distance. And then I am also going to want the delta V current. And I'll move that up to the top. And see, I can reorder them, right? Oh my gosh. There you go. Delta V current up. Delta V current up. Delta V current up. So I've put the Suicide Burn calculator in my current delta V. Let me close this editor and see if I can make this thing appear. Suicide Burn, where are you? There it is. Okay, good deal. Now how do I drag it around? I click on that. That allows me to drag it up to here. Actually, I'll just put it right here because it's really important. I'll put it right there. And I'll just close it. And now I've got an overlay, a wonderful Kerbal Engineer overlay. I know you always see Kerbal Engineer like this, but Kerbal Engineer will actually allow me to do beautiful overlays like that where you can actually see the planet and the beauty behind it, the beauty behind it. So I've got a couple important things here. I've got the delta V in the current stage, which is 437. I'm actually going to F5 for safety right here as well. I've got my Suicide Burn delta V, which was 2706 right now. That's going to be changing as I get closer to the planet, so we're going to watch it. My Suicide Burn distance, that is the distance to my Suicide Burn. I've got my Suicide Burn altitude. That's the altitude that I need to begin burning in order to do this Suicide Burn. Watch, though. We are too high right now for these numbers to be accurate. We're too high for these to be accurate. Ah, Gav beat me! No, I tried, but Gav beat me. Ah! I tried so hard. But in the end, it didn't really matter. Anyways. Do not look at this when you're so high. You have to be going down towards the planet before you can do this. And there's another thing that you have to do to set up this Suicide Burn. You have to be falling down straight towards the planet. You cannot be going around the planet like this. You can't be... Do you see how I'm coming in at a severe angle? How I'm going to be impacting the planet at an angle like that? The Suicide Burn calculator does not work when coming in at angles. Basically, what you want is no horizontal velocity. No horizontal velocity. I need to be falling straight down. So if you're here for my lessons yesterday, you know that if I burn radial in, that's this blue thing, I can actually tweak myself like that and make it so I'm falling straight down. Larry J, dude, 87, thank you and Merry Christmas. Larry J, dude, you are welcome. It does not cost anything to ask questions at my help desk, but I really do appreciate the support, man. Thank you so much for that. That is amazing. Merry Christmas to you as well. I'm going to be streaming all next week during Christmas. During Christmas. I don't know if I use the word fan. I don't know if I'd use the word fan. But yes, we've got it. So we're falling straight down. Again, Larry J, thank you for the support. I really do appreciate it. Feel free to come here anytime. Donations or no donation, come to my channel and ask me questions, and I will do my best. I will do my best to answer them for you. Let's see here. I've got this. I've got that. I need to burn radial in. So let's go ahead and point radial in and do this burn. Super lazy mode here. I'm just going to go ahead and do the burn right now, and I want to burn radial in until I get rid of this Delta V, because I need to be falling straight towards the planet. I need to be falling straight towards the planet. Right leg. Oops, that was too much. Ah, well, I burned way early. That's okay. That is pretty straight close to the planet. I burned a little bit too much, so I'm going to flip my direction here. And I'm going to burn radial out a little bit. Oh, actually, it may be radial in again. I don't know. Let's see here. No, okay, it's radial out still. Until my two lines line up about like this. That means that I'm falling straight towards the planet. You gotta be falling straight towards the planet for a suicide burn. There was another great question from Goldie that came in. Does a suicide burn calculator take into account the different stagings? I believe it's supposed to, but I don't think that that's a safe thing to do. Boy in Blue, Merry Christmas to you as well, man. Thanks for hanging out with us. I don't really trust this. So I'm gonna F5 for safety right here. Actually, let's get closer. Let's fall down towards the moon. And let's get closer to the moon. There we go. That's closer. And I am going to go ahead. Am I still falling straight down? I'm still falling straight down, so that's good. What I would normally do, I'm going to F5 for safety right here. Nice. Enjoy the quotes, but please don't spam them. I love it. Artec, dude, I love that. Thank you. Let's see here. And I am going to, for safety's sake, I am going to ditch this stage. We'll come back and we'll try it with that. With the stage. But I'm going to ditch the stage for the first suicide burn here. I'm going to come back to that F5 for safety right there. So I've gotten rid of that. I'm also going to make sure that this engine is engaged. That's correct. I'm going to deploy my landing gear. That is correct. And I'm going to orient myself dorsal up like this. That means the pod is up at the top here, right? The pod is up here at the top. What I need to do now here, whoa, that was weird. Boy in Blue, my mods are trying to talk to you. I'm gonna talk to you. Chill out. The mods will take care of you. If you keep that up, man. I appreciate you being here, I really do. Just don't be too spammy, don't abuse it. We're falling straight down towards the planet. Lord Tetchy! Das, you are awesome, and I wanted to share the holiday love with you. Keep up the good work and show Twitch why they were losers not to partner you. Oh, my goodness. My goodness. Ah, yes. I'm returning to an orbiter. If you're going in for a landing, why would you need a suicide burn? T-game, why would you need a suicide burn for a non-landing? Suicide burns are only for landings. They're not for rendezvous. For a rendezvous, just half it out. We're cool, T-Boy. We're cool. Blue, Boy in Blue, actually. We're cool, Boy in Blue. Just don't spam my name over and over again, okay? You're cluttering up the chat so other people can't ask questions. Please don't do that. Lord Tetchy, thank you for the support. I really do appreciate it, man. Thank you so much. We're falling straight down. We are just going to, whenever this number here gets to zero, when that number right there gets to zero, we are going to do our burn. So let's fall on down. There's 60. There's 50. There's 40. There's 30. There's 30. There's 20. Alright, here we go. Oh, I apologize. You burn when the distance gets to zero. I need to reorganize this. Wow, hang on. Heek! When the distance gets to zero, you go full throttle. Like that. And you burn, and what you do, you try to modulate the throttle so that that's no more than 100 meters. If you need to give it less throttle, you give it less throttle. If it starts to drop like that, you've got to keep that around 100 meters. If it goes negative, you die. If that right there goes negative, you die. I'm going to need some more buffer on this, I think. And I'm just burning 300, 400. I think I'm going to leave it down to 500 meters until we get closer. The thing about suicide burn calculations, I'm still going half a kilometer per second. If it looks like you're going to die, you're probably doing it right. It always looks like you're going to die if you're doing a suicide burn correctly. That moon is sure coming up fast. That is down to 400. I can't let that drop negative. If that drops negative, that means that I don't have enough distance left. So there's 300, there's 200, there's 100, there's 90, 80, 70, 60, 50, 40, 30, 20, 10, 18, 19. Do you see the moon? Let's turn our lights on. Burn, 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 buddy! Get that burn done! Woo! So close! Look, we're so good though. That's so close! I did it just a little bit wrong! I lost a landing gear and that's all! Stick the landing! Oh no, my engine came off. Sweet! It was so close! It was so close! I didn't do it exactly right. I felt like I had a whole lot of horizontal velocity there. Was this in orbital mode again? That may have been in orbital mode again. But you see the basic principle there. We totally had a bit of a problem. The cool thing is we can still get off the moon because we still have the other engines. Let's see here. Can we lean up? Can we lean up? Nope, that's rotating me. Okay. Oh, those landing gear broke. Those landing gear totally broke. He's good to go. He still has the other two engines. So you can see, suicide burns are a very dangerous thing. I tried too hard. We are still fine, though. We could take back off. Use retrograde and also position to cancel your horizontal velocity. Sergeant Charles, I don't know if that's going to work, though. I think that I wasn't paying attention. I don't think that I was paying attention to the... excuse me. I did F5 for safety. I did F5 for safety. Look at that screenshot, though. Isn't that great? Isn't that great? Again! Let's do it again! I could take back off. I have two little side engines. Oh, I F5 for safety all the way out here. I'm gonna do an Alt F5 out here. Suicide with extra stage, basically. Alright, let's do this again! Let's do this again. Let's get on down. Where's the moon? There's the. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Stop, stop, stop! We're already here! We're already at the moon. Let's try what somebody said in chat. Let's say point retrograde. And we'll just have Jeb constantly doing retrograde. Yes, I was drinking Red Bull. Let's toss that stage. Let's do our gear. Let's make sure that engine is good. Let me reorder this. I had these in the wrong order and I didn't notice it. I actually want my suicide burn distance, my distance to beginning the suicide burn, to be down a little bit. So I'm going to put my suicide burn distance at the bottom. That's what I want. Another very important thing that I think that I should probably have is my horizontal velocity. So let me go over here. I wasn't paying attention to my horizontal velocity, and I needed to be doing that. I'm going to go ahead and put that horizontal speed up there like that. So that looks good. 282 millimeters per second, that should be okay. Okay. You blew up. Surface mode. We need surface mode as well. Did it not switch to surface mode? Let's see what we've got here. I thought I was looking at it, but I don't. Maybe I didn't do it right. Let's try this again. I'm just going to time warp on down to the moon. I'm going to wait until the moon, the suicide burn distance, gets to zero. Then I'm going to kick it in the tail again. There's 15, 14, 13, 12, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Burn right there. And I'm having the Kerbal continue to point retrograde. And I'm suicide burning. And again, this right here, I don't want it to be a kilometer, but I can't let it go negative. If I go negative, I die. T-game, I did. I think I responded to your messages, unless you said something else. Yeah. I answered that. I did answer that. All right, there we go. I'm going to have to pay attention to the suicide burn. That can't go negative. That can't be negative like that. That means that I'm going to need to begin my burn in the ground, which is not a good place to be beginning burns of any sort. I'm going to bring this on up to like 100. We're falling down. We got a great landing spot here. How's my horizontal speed? It's in millimeters per second, which is great. 162. All right, we're going down. We're still going at a quarter of a kilometer per second. 60, 50, 40, 30. I want that to be like 10 when I hit the surface. 16, 17, 10, 9, burn, 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 burn. Keep it there, keep it there, keep it there. Pretty good, except for falling over. Oh, because of the retrograde thing. So that's a terrible idea. The retrograde thing has to be turned off or Jeb has no clue what he's doing. I never thought of that. That was a good suicide landing. That was a good suicide landing. But because Jeb was being told to point at retrograde, he flipped the rocket on its side. I didn't want him to do that. That was a great suicide burn, except for using this retrograde marker. At the last second, right before you do the landing, you've got to change it to stability assist instead of retrograde or prograde. Because he flipped the rocket over. That was great. You have to turn it off at the last minute. Yes, Cantab, that's exactly right. Let me get some followers here. Let me get some followers. Minecraft Geek, Zappit King, Tiny UID, or Tin UID, Lost in the Sauce, Becky, thanks for the follow, Pure Evil, Snorlax Sumo, Zai, thanks for joining us here at the Help Desk. I appreciate y'all. That was a good... excuse me. That was a good suicide burn. I guess we could put it up on its nose, couldn't we? No, we could probably take off again. Watch, if I needed to upright this rocket, let me show you a trick. I would probably do this, and I would probably activate this engine, and I would probably shut down the main engine, and I would probably try, I would actually retract the landing gear. See, we didn't even break the landing gear, and I would put that engine down. Oh, I would also want to face downhill. I definitely want to face downhill. So I'd put that engine on the downhill side. Wait a second. All right, and I would roll so that engine was down like that. And I would probably try to, yep, light that engine and lean myself. Come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Nope. Not helping. Come on. I'm just too heavy. I've got too much fuel in there. Uh-oh, well, we're going at least. We've got that going for us. Why don't we just light all the engines and see what happens? Nothing good. Nothing good. At least we know the temperature. That's important. At least we know the temperature. Ah, yes. Ninja, you gotta change it to radial out. Prograde won't help you. You gotta... Wait, what? Oh, radial out. That makes a lot of sense. Radial out. Or just turn it off. I would just go to a stability assist, I think. Let's go to F9. We're gonna reload that last save. See where that gets me to. Alright. Let's go down and do another one. Let's do another one. I'm gonna tell him to point retrograde. I'm gonna ditch that stage. I'm gonna time warp until the suicide burn distance gets down to zero. I'm gonna put out my gear. Well, I can't do that while I'm time warping. There's 200, 150, 100, there's 50, 40, 30, 20, 10, 9, 8. Now I'm gonna do my gear. I've got Jeb pointing me retrograde. We're going down to that big crater, which is fine. And when that gets to zero, I'm gonna kick it in the rear, just like I said. The butter squid, what's going on? And Hussein Kadim, thanks for following. I'm gonna light the candle when that suicide burn distance gets to zero. Let's try it again. Right like that. And then I'm gonna modulate it so it doesn't get very high above 100. Modulate it, I mean I'm giving it less throttle. You see my throttle going down? I just want it to hold, right like that. We're falling down in that crater. Don't get under 100. I can't suicide. Oops, good. Now I can move to Dr. Pepper. I'm just watching that. I can't let that get too low. If that gets negative, I die. I probably die anyways. It's Jamesy! Thanks for the follow. There we go. And let me see if I can't... I wish the nav ball wasn't there, you know? There, I'll point the camera down for you. 50, 40, 30. I gotta keep that up above 100. Right until the landing. Turn my lights on, then you'll be able to see. Okay, good. 92, 91, 88, 87. Look at that ground coming up. That I burned. I was way too conservative that time. But still, it makes for an easy landing. I was just very, very, very conservative. That time I was worried about making Jeb come over. I was worried about Jeb, and I didn't pay any attention to the rocket. Very interesting. Very interesting indeed. What can I do to get him to take off? There's got to be something I can do. Could I just pull up? No, that won't work. Could I do that? No, that didn't work. I could just edge to the edge of a hill. It makes for an easy landing. It did, because I've never used those new pilot tools before, and if I was doing this without the pilot tools, I think I would be fine. I just know the pilot tools. I'm not very good at using those pilot tools because I'm so used to not letting a computer fly for me. It's not looking good, honestly. Still has landing gear. What do we lose? Everything! That's okay, we're just installing TPs on the moon. Breakdance the lander, heck yeah. Heck yeah, alright. I was gonna do it with the smaller engine, so let's try the smaller engines left, and then we'll go on to the other one. I'm gonna do it without all this stability assist stuff. I'm just gonna do it myself this time. I don't trust those computers to fly for me. Let's just turn SAS on is okay, but I'm not gonna use the rest of this stuff. What's my horizontal speed? Excellent. Let's get on down again. Oh, let's try it with the other engines. Here we go. Yeah, we're living through every single one of these. We're totally living through every single one. We're just playing with different parameters here. What if I do that? And I do that. So this is a suicide landing with a lot lower... Whoa, it's already too late! From right here, these cannot actually suicide burn us. Let me see. I'm gonna try it. That's actually very interesting. I don't know. Wow, look how high we are. And with this low thrust to weight, look at how far away we have to be get the suicide burn. That's very interesting, honestly. That's very interesting, all the other. Break dance does not mean dance until you break. I love it. Fort Chicken Swag! And Brandy the Bow. Thanks for the follows, guys. I think this may be able to do it, because look at that suicide burn distance dropping. That gets shaked up. Dr. Pepper! My Dr. Pepper was mad at me! How? My Dr. Pepper... Oh my goodness! My Dr. Pepper was so angry at me for drinking a Red Bull. And it's been sitting on my desk in a koozie... for an hour. And it just exploded all over the desk. Oh my gosh. My Dr. Pepper is becoming self-aware, I think, because it is mad at me. It just spewed all over the place after sitting in my desk. You have to be... I don't understand. I've never seen that happen before. The Dr. Pepper has been sitting on my desk, not moving. For I don't know how long, and it just freaking exploded all... I'm sorry, honey. I didn't mean to... Jeez, oh, Pete. Jeez, oh, Pete. But I was going to drink you, and it, like, totally chewed me out! I'm cleaning up. Hang on. I could actually... I should stop burning. There. Okay. Take it easy, Nubius. Dr. Pepper. It's okay, sweetie. You knew I'd come back to you. Oh my gosh. That is... Is there anything in there? Dr. Pepper didn't betray me. I betrayed Dr. Pepper, I think it was. How did it do that? Oh my gosh. Sorry, guys. Hang on a second. Bad news. Derpinator, I do, because I eat pizza here all the time. Oh my gosh. How do you change the symmetry mode? Press R. Somebody watch that. Tell me if I need to burn. Alright. Okay. Are we cool now, Dr. Pepper? Can I drink you? Gosh! Now I can't actually... Nah, no need to pause the game. Now it won't let me open it up! This is worse than... Girlfriend. Jeez, oh, Pete. There you go. Eventually you can pry it open. All right. We got it done. Let's try the suicide burn with the little engines here. You built your first working plane, took off and landed using FAR. Thanks to our student, Guntuga. Congratulations. Congratulations. Burn now. I love you guys. Try.